Hi everyone, I'm Rosie and this is my book, Counting on Love. I'm going to read a little excerpt from it today for you. So Zoe has been chosen to attend a high-flying conference with her boss, Raina, in Alice Springs. And unbeknownst to Raina, Zoe has a giant crush on her. Raina, however, is very caught up in her own world, which includes raising her orphaned nephew and obviously being the boss of the firm. In this scene, Zoe has convinced Raina to go on an early morning bike ride with her in Alice Springs. She's a bit of an adventurer, Zoe. When Zoe's alarm finally sounded, she woke with a start and quickly switched it off, the sound grating against the silence of the desert morning. She cleaned her teeth and dressed in layers by the light of her bedside lamp. It was cold and dark now, but she knew from yesterday morning that by the time the sun came up, it would be warm enough to shed her jacket on the ride back to the hotel. Switching off the lamp, she let herself quietly out of her room, careful not to let the door slam and wake her sleeping neighbours. She jogged down the stairwell rather than waiting for the lift and made her way to Raina's unit, enjoying the absolute stillness around her. The birds were not awake yet, and there was nothing moving at the hotel. At Raina's door, she tapped quietly and took a step back, wondering if Raina had managed to wake up on time. Would she be ready? Would she have changed her mind? She leaned against the door frame while she waited. Should she tap again? Would that seem rude? If Raina was still asleep, there wouldn't be any point in waking her now. Perhaps Zoe could just creep away and do the ride on her own as she had originally planned. It had been ridiculous to think that Raina, the CEO of her firm, would want to join her on a dawn bike ride. Maybe she would tap just once more, and if she still didn't answer, she would leave. She raised her hand to knock, and the door swung open, leaving Zoe standing at the doorway with her fist in the air. She quickly put it down, trying not to stare as Raina stepped out onto the pathway. She was wearing a pair of soft grey track pants, baby blue flats, and a puffer jacket zipped up to her chin. Her hair was damp as if she had just showered, a loose strand stuck to her cheek. Zoe had to shove her hands in her pockets to try to resist the urge to reach out and tuck it behind her ear. Raina looked younger without her makeup, almost vulnerable in the shadows of the pre-dawn. "Sorry, I was just looking for my jacket." "No worries, ready to go?" "As I'll ever be." Raina shot her a hesitant smile as if she had been debating the merits of this experience with herself and lost. "You might have to go slow for me. I'm not a big professional athlete like you." "You'll be fine. Come on, let's get the bikes." The helmets were stored on a shelf at the back of the rec shed and Zoe grabbed two, tossing one to Raina. "Pretty sure they're just one size fits all, so try that on." She wheeled her bike out into the open and adjusted the straps on her helmet. Raina appeared to be struggling with hers. "You all right?" "I can't seem to shorten the straps." "Here, let me help you." Zoe rested her bike on the ground and took the straps from Raina's hands, sliding the toggle up the strap in order to shorten it. "Try that." Raina fumbled with the straps, trying to meet the two ends together under her chin. "I've got it." Zoe took the two ends and gently clipped them together, careful to avoid touching Raina's skin. It would be so easy to run her thumb along Raina's cheek, to graze her lips with her own. Her abdomen constricted, her heart thudding, heat spread through her. She took a step back and said quickly, "That should do it." The ride out to Anzac Hill was an easy flat route. She remembered it well enough from the previous day that she didn't have to stop and check the directions. They rode silently side by side through the darkness. A few cars passed them, their headlights illuminating the road and the surrounding gum trees for a brief moment, and then they were picking their way through the darkness by the light of the torch on Zoe's mobile phone. "I did ask the hotel if they had any bike lights, but unfortunately they don't," Zoe apologised as they pedalled down a long straight road. "I didn't think to bring mine with me, but we're actually nearly there." "I don't mind. It's kind of nice riding in the dark. Makes it feel like an adventure. Anyway, my eyes are pretty much adjusted now." Adventuring with Raina, Zoe thought. Who would have imagined that? She felt a little thrill run through her as she pushed off the pedals and stood, letting the bike coast for a moment. She felt good. She felt free. "Now you're just showing off." "What? No, it's fun, that's all. You should try it." "I'd fall off." "Nah, it's harder to fall off a bike than you think. Once you get moving, you've just got to look straight ahead to keep your balance." Raina followed her instructions, looking straight ahead as she pedaled some more, and then suddenly she too stood on her pedals. "Woo!" she called, shaking her head in the breeze. "I'm doing it!" Her bike gave a small wobble and she sank back down on her seat, laughing. "I haven't done that for an age." Zoe's heart soared like a bird on an updraft. If I could sing, she thought, I would want to do that right now. Sadly, her voice was about as bird-like as a crow. Regardless, she felt weightless, like she'd been airlifted out of her normal life and dropped into a moment that had been reserved especially for them. It's pretty good, isn't it? She called, pedaling hard to feel the rush of air against her face. The sign for Anzac Hill loomed in the darkness and she pulled up, waiting for Rayner. Hey, you said you'd go easy on me, Lance Armstrong. Sorry, Zoe grinned. We can leave the bikes and walk up from here. They dismounted, linking their bikes together with the chain Zoe had procured from the hotel, and headed up a small gravel track. As the track got steeper, their pace slowed and Rayner slipped, her foot sliding out from under her on a loose stone. Zoe reached out her hand and grabbed her by the elbow, holding her up. Rayner gave a shaky laugh. Got you, Zoe said. I don't think my shoes are really cut out for this. I didn't actually bring any runners with me. That's okay, we're nearly there. Just hang on to me until we reach the top. Zoe linked her arm through Rayner's, holding her close to support her as they finished the last few meters of steep ascent. As fit as she was, she felt breathless, as if she was finishing Everest, conscious of Rayner's body pressed against her own. At the top, they stood for a moment, arms still linked, watching as the morning lights began to flicker on in the township. There were others dotted around the top of the hill, getting out cameras and tripods, obviously gathering to watch the sunrise. We made it then, Rayner said quietly, her body warm against Zoe's. Want to sit down? Zoe suggested as they looked around the hill. Sure. We should sit on the side where the sun comes up. There's an empty bench. Reluctantly, she let Rayner's arm slip from her own, and they made their way over to the bench and sat down. She checked her watch. The sky was beginning to glisten with the first hint of red light dawn. It won't be long now. So that's just a little excerpt from Counting on Love by RL Burgess. That's me. And if you would like to read the rest of it, you can get it from Bella Books and all other excellent booksellers. So thanks very much for listening and have a great day.